What's up, guys? Leekum here again. Day 5, let's get right into it.
I bring you the Twirling Furbish. Have you ever been playing against Messi and he puts so many moves on you that you can't see straight? Try this sleeping technique to improve your balance. Twirling a full 360 degrees 12 times per night will help you build an internal balance that will allow you to defend any soccer player with ease. Guys, all jokes aside, Emloy designs mattresses built to enhance your recovery and improve your performance. Their sleep scientists have crafted a memory foam series that enhances your blood and oxygen circulation, improving the deep sleep you need to wake up at your best. Comment hashtag GoLooSleep and follow Emloy on social media for a chance to win a signed Manchester United jersey. Details in the description below. Now, on to the video.
Right, what's good, guys? Tyler back, Team Goal with Remy. Today we've got a special guest for you guys, Argentinian national team, Manchester United goalkeeper, one and only Sergio Romero. No, I don't know. We don't need any field players. We don't need any field players in here. This is goalkeepers only. So today, Sergio's gonna be giving us some advice, help you guys keep the ball out of the net, which is what we all want. So let's go. Kick it, flick it in with the greatest. Y'all, what you dream? Now go make it. Don't get anxious. Put in that work, then go get famous. All right, so the first situation we're going over is one of the hardest saves in all of goalkeeping. It's a 1v1 save. Striker's coming straight down the middle of the field. Your defenders aren't there. They can shoot left or right, and we're really just left on an island on our own. So, first off, when you have a, say, 1v1 save, you've already gotten close to the ball. Yeah. What stance do you usually like to be in? Like,
For me, the first thing is, you need to do one or two steps out of the goal.
Yes.
Because the goal is so big.
Big, yeah.
And when you do one or two, they
get smaller.
Yeah,
get so it gets smaller. Yeah. So once you get to the point where, say, you're only a few yards from the ball, and as you get closer and closer, you get lower and lower normally.
Yeah, this is the normal situation, but you need to know also the striker.
Yes.
Because if you have Messi in front, you know, you go low and the ball is going up.
Over top. So that was going to be another question is, so it does depend on the player of how low or high you want to set.
Yeah.
With your hand placement, do you like to put your hands low, down low, or do you like to keep them a little higher up? It matters.
For me, the more difficult in the moment is the player, because when you go and you can run, you know, the hand is just in the position for cover the space. But after this, if you go too many low, it's also difficult for move the legs.
Yes.
You are dead.
Yes. So you'd say a lot of times you get lower, maybe keep your hands a little bit higher, and then your feet will cover the low balls, and your hands can cover anything that comes high.
Yes.
What would you do when you have an attacker that wants to dribble you in this 1v1 situation?
It's why I said.
So if I come
at
you.
If you go here, and you don't have more the legs.
Okay.
And if you know, it's a little bit more higher.
Sure. Yeah. Your butt. Yeah, keep it high.
And you can run, or maybe you can run one pass and go.
And dive. Okay.
So then another very common way of saving these is a split save. So when he's coming out, right, his main contact is when you're kicking, you're just kicking your leg out, trying to cover the low ball, putting your hands out. When he's coming straight down, are you looking at what foot, you know what his preferred foot is or what his strong foot is? Does that change which leg you want to kick out?
This is the first thing.
Yes.
If he's left or right, this is the first thing. And after voy a hablar en español un poquito.
Bueno.
Voy a separar la situación.
Sí.
Porque el hecho de ir así es muy europeo.
Exacto.
Es muy alemán.
Sí, bueno.
Pero nosotros en Sudamérica vamos más cerrados.
Okay. Sí.
No jugamos el cuerpo en una situación, sino que tratamos de mantener la posición por si tenemos que seguir corriendo.
Okay, exactamente. Bueno, tiene sentido. I know you didn't understand any of that, but he's saying essentially, in Europe, they come with their bodies.
Big, yes.
And obviously in South America and Argentina, they move a little bit in order to gain that position.
So you like the more controlled movements than just come flying out okay. All right, so here we're dealing with one of the most common 1v1 situations. It's where a player's coming in from out wide, closing in on our goal from inside the box. And in these situations, if you try to just react on the ball, we don't have time to react.
Yeah.
You need to know where he's gonna shoot before he shoots. And you need to get your body in front of the ball, because if you try to react, it's too slow. You're never going to make a save.
It's difficult.
Yeah. So if he's, say, we got Will here on his left foot, what are you looking for here to try to get a read on where you think he's going to shoot, near post, far post, curler, hard?
Yeah. The first thing for us is keep the position.
Yes.
We need to keep the position, because if we go before, it's open.
Yeah.
We open the other side if we keep the position. And also, the first thing is when he come the ball, if he have the control in the ball,
it's
safe. But sometimes the strikers, when the ball is coming, mm-hmm. it's coming, they lose the view of the goalkeeper. Because they want to control the ball, mm-hmm. and this is the moment we go.
Step. Yeah. If the field player has control of the ball, you can't take it. But you're actually looking. If he's looking at the ball too much, you're looking at his eyes down the ball, and then you realize that he's not going to see you come in.
Yeah, it's the moment for one or two steps
to step.
Yeah,
and then the last again here, the kick save is a great option. Normally, I've always been taught is you want to kick save to cover the back post because that's where the curler is what they're going to try. So is that normally what you would look at?
And we know the we have maybe 1 meter to the first post, and we can cover with the feet or with
the body.
But when it's open and he's a left foot, can do around our hand, and that is difficult. But all depends the distance, because if you are here, for him it's more difficult to put the ball there.
What do you do to make sure that you don't get megged through your legs? Because that's also very difficult to stop. Is there any secrets that you have to so it never happens?
It's not a secret, but you know, this is the sometimes we need to lucky. Yeah. We need to have a little bit of lucky.
Yes.
But it's the most important, you know, if you are like this, you are dead.
Body weight forward.
Yeah. Yes.
Body weight forward, and you can
the chest in forward. The position forward and clean the mint. Yeah. This is the first thing. If you have the mint clean, you can react in the moment.
Yes.
Also, in the more difficult ball, you can react.
Right.
But if you are
thinking
in
too
trouble,
much. Yes. Because the saves, your best saves, you usually don't even remember what you're thinking. You don't remember what you did. You're just on the ground. The ball's over the post.
You see the ball out, and you say, okay, next.
Finish. So, last question. Is this is something that I've seen you specifically do. I don't see a lot of goalkeepers do. Is when a ball is being played out here, and they're going to cut it back, you'll go with your feet first. I think on Wednesday you had a very nice play where you're coming in and you're actually coming in with your feet first to the ball.
Because it's in this situation is I don't remember the name of the striker, but he drives after Maguire.
Yeah.
And the ball is long.
Yes.
And this is my moment.
So, but most goalkeepers I would see, they would go with their hands to that ball.
Yeah.
Why do you prefer to go with your feet?
Because Scared is the
miedo. Tienes un poco miedo.
No, él.
Ah, él tiene miedo. he does it because it's scarier for the other attacker.
You see,
if we go to the hands with the hands,
the
striker can put the feet like this.
Yeah,
and my hands,
your hands are
there. If you go with your feet, I jump.
Yeah. So you go with your feet
for sure. If you don't jump, and I take the ball. Yeah.
So that's you thinking, if I do this once to this player, the next time the ball comes in, he's going to say, no, I'm done, finished.
Yeah.
Awesome. Okay,
It's why great. Also when this is a corner or a free kick, we go with the right knee or left knee in the high.
Yes.
Because if I touch the striker one time,
they don't come back.
For sure,
they don't come back. Yeah. So last question, I have a little bit of experience with this, being American playing in Croatia. You obviously from Argentina, you've played in France, Italy, the Netherlands, now England.
Yeah.
As a goalkeeper, when you come onto a new club, we hear a lot of kids asking like, oh, I want to go play overseas. I want to go play in another country. When you come onto a new club, you're instantly supposed to be the backbone of the team, a leader, vocal. And it's very difficult when you're coming into where you don't know the language, you don't know the culture, you're not used to the play style, they're not used to your play style. Do you have any tips for how you quickly integrate to mesh like onto a team and like fit into a team when you first come to a new environment?
For us it's easy because we are South American, you know. Mm-hmm. And when you are there, your dream is arrive in Europe.
Mm.
And I arrived in Europe, I was 20 years. I go to Holland.
Yes.
Cultura. Different culture.
Culture different.
Culture.
Different food. Different language,
yes.
Two different languages.
Yeah.
But I keep going. I said, this is my moment, this is my opportunity, it's one in the life, and I need to catch,
take with
me, and keep going.
Yeah. So is there anything you did that made it easier to like quickly adapt to that culture? Would you do for that?
For sure. For sure. It's easy.
It's just easy.
After this is easy because you are clear. Mm-hmm. You know what you want.
So you just see football is football wherever you are.
Yeah.
And that's just it's the same game and you're just gonna go play your game essentially.
The game is the same. Just the difference is the players.
Yes.
In Argentina we have a lot of good player, a lot of very good players, but when you come this in this side, the pitch is different.
Yeah.
It's wet, it's with water.
Yeah, it's the mud. Yeah. Yeah.
It's with the rain, weather, yes. Rain, yeah, wind, yeah. All yeah. In one day or all in one in 90 minutes.
Yes.
Yeah. And you need to keep going the mentality.
Tu mentalidad. Yeah. Bueno, puedes decirlo en español si quieres.
Tienes que estar mentalmente 100% concentrado en tu trabajo.
Exacto.
Y en lo que quieres.
Sí, y todo eso, y con esa mentalidad, bueno, vas a tener un poco de éxito.
Sin lugar a duda. Sí. Sin lugar a duda.
All right, man, thanks for so much for coming out, giving us these tips. I know a bunch of keepers are going to find this really useful who want to get to your level, get to the top, because obviously you've done a bunch of things right in your career to get to where you are right now. And just thanks for coming out.
Yeah.
It's great talking to you.
Appreciate it.
Muchas gracias por la invitación.
Sí, no, bueno, de nada.
All right, you guys, that's the video. Make sure you want to just make sure they subscribe.
Yeah, tell them to subscribe. Yeah. Bueno, en español, puedes decirlo.
Pueden suscribirse lo antes posible, que hay videos que sí. La verdad que tienen muchas cosas técnicas de
sí, exactamente. What he lo said. Que dijo. Bueno, chao. Don't rate me fa sol la hit is gon' do rate me control all them boys from Kansas City where they know we got them tricks. We get it how we live and know we all about